In the name of Allah, the Almighty. Dear students, Assalamu Alaikum. Our today's topic is sources of long-term finance. This is entrepreneurship, included in entrepreneurship. Also, this is a chapter in business studies, so very important chapter, sources of long-term finance. Dear students, you already are aware that the finance is the lifeblood of every business enterprise. Finance jo hai, har business mein zarurat hai. Aur ye finance hasil karne ke liye different sources hote hai. Kuch sources long term finance ke liye hai, aur kuch short term finance ke liye hai. Aur jo aaj to hum long term sources ke bare mein padhne ja rahe hain, to mukhtalif tareekon se hum paisa apne business ke liye hasil kar sakte hain. The first source is issuance of shares. First of all, what is a share? Shares are the most universal form of raising long-term funds from the public. The capital of a company is divided into a number of equal parts. Those parts are known as shares. So we can say share is a unit into which the total capital of a company is divided. Company ka asasa jo hai, isko chote chote hisson mein baant kar bech diya jata hai. Paison ke avaz bech diya jata hai. Iske avaz paise jama kiye jate hain. To unko hum shares kehte hain. There are two types of shares. Two types of shares are issued. One is preference shares and second is equity shares. Preference shares, the shares which carry a preferential right over equity shares with reference to payment of dividend. Jab dividend payment kiya jata hai, jis share ko preference milti hai, jin shareholders ko preference milti hai dividend बांटते वक्त, उनको प्रेफरेंस शेयर्स कहा जाता है, प्रेफरेंस शेयर होल्डर्स कहा जाता है. द रिपेमेंट ऑफ कैपिटल जब किया जाता है तो प्रेफरेंस शेयर होल्डर को सबसे पहले रिपेमेंट की जाती है. द रेट ऑफ डिविडेंड is fixed in case of preference shareholders. They have nothing to do with profit and loss. If the company suffers loss, they are not responsible. Now the second type of shares is equity shares. They are also known as ordinary shares. The equity shareholders are real owners of the company. They are real owners. They have a share in profit and they have also a share in loss. They are paid dividend after paying it to the preference shareholders. Jab preference shareholder ki claim khatam ho jati hai, uske baad jo kuch bachta hai, wo equity shareholders ko diya jata hai. The rate of dividend depends upon the profit of the company. जितना ज़्यादा प्रॉफिट कंपनी कमाएगी उतने उसी के हिसाब से उनको रेट ऑफ डिविडेंड मिलता है. द सेकंड सोर्स ऑफ लॉन्ग टर्म फाइनेंस इज इशू ऑफ डिबेंचर्स और बॉन्ड्स. व्हाट इज अ डिबेंचर? अ डिबेंचर और अ बॉन्ड इज एन एक्नॉलेजमेंट ऑफ अ डेट. कंपनी किसी आदमी से कर्जा हासिल करती है तो इसके इवज में उसको एक सर्टिफिकेट देता है, एक रिसिप्ट देता है. सो अ डिबेंचर और अ बॉन्ड इज एन एक्नॉलेजमेंट ऑफ अ डेट. इट्स अ सर्टिफिकेट issued by the company under its seal acknowledging a debt due by it to its holders. यानी कितना कर्जा लिया है इसकी एक सर्टिफिकेट कंपनी देती है उस आदमी को जिससे ये कर्जा हासिल किया जाता है. तो इस सर्टिफिकेट को ही हम डिवेंचर कहते हैं. डिवेंचर सर्टिफिकेट इट्स अ सोर्स ऑफ रेजिंग लॉन्ग टर्म कैपिटल. डिवेंचर होल्डर इज पेड इंटरेस्ट एंड इज ऑल्सो क्रेडिटर ऑफ द कंपनी. ये कर्जदार होता है, कंपनी इसका कर्जदार होती है. डिवेंचर कैन बी डिफाइंड एज एन एक्नॉलेजमेंट दैट द कंपनी हैज़ बोरोड अ सर्टन सम ऑफ मनी विच इट प्रोमिसेस टू रिपे एट अ फ्यूचर डेट. नेक्स्ट सोर्स ऑफ रेजिंग लॉन्ग टर्म फाइनेंस इज लोन फ्रॉम फाइनेंशियल इंस्टीट्यूशंस. Financial institutions like LIC, UTI, Unit Trust of India, IDBI, Industrial Development Bank of India, ICICI, etc. have been established all over the country to provide financial help to the business organizations. ऐसे institutions जो हैं इन्हीं इसीलिए इस्टेब्लिश हुए होते हैं ताकि एक बिजनेस पर्सनस को हेल्प करें, इनको फाइनेंशियल हेल्प प्रोवाइड करें. दोज इंस्टीट्यूशंस आर टर्म्ड एज डेवलपमेंट बैंक्स एंड प्रोवाइड लोन्स फॉर मीडियम एज वेल एज लॉन्ग टर्म रिक्वायरमेंट ऑफ द बिजनेस. द फोर्थ सोर्स इज रिटेन्ड अर्निंग्स. इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट सोर्स. Retained earnings is also known as plowing back of capital, plowing back of profit. So when the business earns profit, it keeps some profit unspent and it invests this profit also in the business. That is known as retained earnings. The part of profit which is not distributed among the shareholders as dividend but is retained in the business for use in future is known as retained earnings. It is also known as plowing back of profit or self-financing and important source of internal finance. It is internal finance. It is a long-term source of finance. Next source of finance is loan from commercial banks. Commercial banks occupy an important position in providing funds for long term, short term as well as the medium term requirements of the business. Business mein jo bhi zarurat hai, kisi bhi zarurat ko, chahe long term ho, short term ho, medium term ho, zarurat ko pura karne ke liye commercial banks loans provide करते हैं. They provide loans for purchase of assets. They provide loans for meeting day-to-day expenses, for running the business. They provide financial help in the form of term loans, cash credit, discounting of bills, overdrafts, etc. So these are the five sources of long-term finance. Tomorrow we will discuss sources of short-term finance. That's all for today. Goodbye.